y Manaya Canguichi, Ñukashuti, Migam, Miriam Masakisa, Quichua, Ecuador, Mamayak Tamanda, Ñukami Yankani, Kai Hatunwasi, Naciones Unidas, Nishkapi. Hello everybody, my name is Miriam Masakisa and I am Quichua from Ecuador and I work as a social affairs officer at the Secretariat of the Permanent Forum on Indigenous Issues, the Indigenous Peoples and Development Branch. Today I will be talking to you about the Permanent Forum, the mandate, the members, how we will be organizing this year's sessions. So let's start. As you know, the Permanent Forum is an advisory body of the ECOSOC, which is the Economic and Social Council. It was established in the year 2000. The first session of the forum was organized here in New York in the year 2002. The mandates of the Permanent Forum are to deal with issues related to economic and social development, the environment, culture, education, health, and human rights. The Permanent Forum also has specific issues within its mandate. One of them is to provide recommendations to UN agencies and also to member states through ECOSOC. The other mandate is to promote and disseminate information about indigenous people's issues. And another one, which is really important, is to coordinate among the United Nations system the work that needs to be done related to indigenous peoples. 7 years later, in 2007, when the Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples was adopted, another additional mandate was given to the forum, which is disseminate and also promote the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. So those are more or less in general the mandates of the Permanent Forum. So now let's talk a little bit on the composition of this forum. There are 16 members. 8 are nominated by member states, and those are elected by the Economic and Social Council. The other 8 are nominated by indigenous people's organizations, and those are appointed by the ECOSOC. So that's the difference. The member states are elected by ECOSOC, and the indigenous people's members are appointed by the president of ECOSOC. So all this activity is done through consultation. They take into account the rotation, the geographical participation, even gender. So that's an important issue to take into account. The members are experts. They work in a capacity level, and they are they usually can be nominated again for another term, and they the duration of the term is for 2 years. So now also I would like to mention that the Permanent Forum is one of the mechanisms of indigenous peoples within the United Nations system. The others are the Special Rapporteur on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples and the Expert Mechanism on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. These two are supported, their work is facilitated by the OHCHR and by a similar organization like us in Geneva. The Permanent Forum is, well, the secretariat where I work is based here in New York, and we facilitate the work of the members, but also we have another set of functions, which is we are the substantial office here in New York regarding indigenous people's issues. So now let me also share with you that through the years, now would be the 20th session of the Permanent Forum, each year the members of the forum decide on different themes, not only the ones that are mandated, but also different themes. For example, through the year, The members have discussed indigenous women, indigenous languages, land, territories and resources, development with identity, indigenous human rights defenders, past peace security, all these issues that these issues that indigenous peoples have said during the sessions of the permanent forum. Perhaps you will think that the forum only functions 2 weeks when they meet here in New York. Well, that's not the reality. The members of the forum usually are invited, for example, by UN agencies, by different states to speak about indigenous issues. So that's why it's really important the outcome of each session, which is the report, because that gives a background and also gives the mandate to the members of the forum to go and speak about these particular issues on indigenous issues. Of course, the members always respect the voice of the indigenous movements. So now I would like to tell you maybe 2 examples of how the members of the forum have taken into consideration the main issues that indigenous peoples have said. For example, I think in 2006, the members of the forum decided that indigenous language should be one of the priorities. So that's why they organized 2 expert group meetings on indigenous languages. Once this happened, the members have lobbied different member states. There is actually a group of friends of indigenous peoples, which is composed by more than 17 member states. So they include in their annual resolution, the General Assembly adopts an annual resolution. So they ask to the General Assembly to declare the year of, in the International Year of Indigenous Languages. So that happened in 2019. So building on that, because the big movement started on what was the situation, how many languages are disappearing, and what's going to happen if every week, every 2 weeks, a language dies. So then nowadays, there are a lot of preparation. UNESCO is the lead agency, and our office, DESA, is also providing support as much as we can. So that's one particular example. Another example is the issues of indigenous women. Indigenous women has been always with the struggle with indigenous peoples. But when they came to the permanent forum, also they wanted to highlight what were the unique contributions, but also the painful situations for them. So that's why in the year 2003, the permanent forum decided to dedicate as a special theme indigenous women. So because of that, little by little, indigenous organizations in the Americas, in Africa, and in other regions established networks, and they start really becoming more visible. So the forum adopted all these recommendations, and there were different aspects, for example, violence against indigenous women, access to justice, political participation, all these issues were present in these recommendations. So because of that, the forum asked the Commission on the Status of Women to also give a focus on indigenous women. Maybe you don't know what is the Commission on the Status of Women. So this commission is the largest commission where all women around the world come together. And actually, right now, they have a meeting. We are in March. So they have a meeting, and they discuss different issues about women. But they really didn't wanted to break down who are indigenous women, or rural women, or migrant women. So indigenous women certainly wanted to have a voice in this particular commission. So they work together, and then in the year 2015, if I am not mistaken, the commission discussed and dedicated a particular session dedicated to indigenous women. And there is, of course, a document, an outcome also there that I really would like to invite you to read about that. All this information is on the website. So you can see how it's important and why it's important that your voices come through this platform, which is the Permanent Forum on Indigenous Issues. So now let me tell you a little bit how usually the report is prepared. So every 2 weeks, the sessions of the forum, many Indigenous peoples will speak, will provide statements, will talk to the members of the forum, and those become recommendations. As I mentioned before, the membership is composed by 16 experts. So all of them must be in consensus in a particular recommendation so that can be included in the outcome, in the report of the permanent forum. So that's how you, at the end, which is usually on Friday, you will find these recommendations are reflected. So that's why, of course, in previous year, it was really important that this platform give you the opportunity to talk to UN agencies, to other Indigenous peoples organizations, to NGOs, even to member states, to let them know that you are here and what is your aspiration and how you could work together with a member state. So now, of course, due to the COVID-19, unfortunately, last year's session was postponed, and this session will have a different looking, if we can say. So now let me tell you how we are trying and organizing this session. So the session will start from 19 to 13 April. It would be 2 in-person sessions, and all of them would be virtual. So which means that the in-person sessions would be, the participants would be members of the permanent forum and one delegate from member states. Unfortunately, this time, Indigenous peoples will not travel to New York and they will be not coming to the UN premises. So the other sessions would be online. So we are trying to make sure that Indigenous peoples participate fully in these important meetings. We can understand that many Indigenous organizations, due to the electricity or access to internet, it would be a little bit challenging. But this is the platform, so we need to take advantage of that. So it would be only 2-hour sessions in the mornings. So you can understand that taking the floor or making statements really would be a challenge. But one way on how you can do that is that you will be able to send your statement, provide your recommendations. So we will have, we have actually on our website the platform where you can send these recommendations. If it's possible, maybe you should be also creative. In 1 minute, perhaps you can record a video in your place, giving us this wake up of what's happening in your community, but also tell us how you, do you think that this should be a good way to do it. A recommendation. So that's very, very important. So maybe in 1 minute you can also do that. I really would like to encourage doing that. Another way on how to participate is organizing side events. As this time we were not looking for rooms or anything, any of you could organize side events. But very important, 2 things. In order to participate and take the floor or make a statement and also to organize a side event, you have to register through Indigo. That's the platform that you need to do. You will get a link and then you would be able to participate. So, and others, of course, all these meetings would be webcasted. So it would be open to any of you. So, but if you want to really to speak or to organize side events, you must register in Indigo. So this information also is available on the website. So what else I can share with you? Yeah, another important aspect is maybe two things, milestones of this very important participation of indigenous peoples here. One of them is the World Conference on Indigenous Peoples. The outcome is a document that member states agree, and those are commitments that they made when they adopt this document. So this, for example, would be one of the discussions at the permanent forum session. And another aspect that I would like to share with you is that as last year, the session was postponed, all the documents that were going to be discussed would be discussed this year. Plus, the members added this very painful issue about COVID-19. So those are the information that you would be able to find on the website. I don't want to give you different titles. I think that you would be better place to check on the website and see. We are trying to give you all the links to documents, those you will find in different languages. So we invite you to read those and also check the conclusions and recommendations. So maybe those would be pertinent for you. So I think that's all what I can share for now. So thank you very much for your time.